Jai Swaminarayan students, children, today we are going to do page number 32 and 33. Let us start with traditional paintings of India. Okay, how much do you really know about Indian paintings? Read this to know about the different styles of traditional Indian paintings. Now we have some different topics on Indian traditional paintings. Let us just see them one by one. First is Pattachitra. It is derived from the words Patta and Chitra. Patta means canvas and Chitra means picture. Most of the themes of national Pattachitra are based on Hindu mythology. This form of cloth-based scroll painting is mainly rooted in Orissa. Now, this kind of painting is found in Orissa, right? It is cloth-based painting. That canvas, it is a cloth-based material. And this Pattachitra is drawn on that. Next is Madhubani painting. It has striking geometrical patterns which are traditionally done on a freshly plastered or mud wall with natural dyes and pigments. Right? The natural dyes, natural colors and pigments are used to draw this. The paintings are basically of a ritual nature for particular occasions such as birth, marriage, festivals, right? The special occasion like birth, marriage, festivals, this all occasions are mostly drawn on the drawn in this painting. The main feature of this style from the Mithila region of Bihar is that it usually leaves no empty space on the canvas. Each and every space on the canvas is drawn on it, right? Next is Tanjore painting. It is originated in Thanjavur, a region in Tamil Nadu. Tanjore painting, which mainly depicts sacred icons, are made by placing layers of cloth on the wooden plank. They also use rich and vivid colors, gold foil, inlays of glass, and even semi-precious stones. So in this kind of painting, not only colors are used, but wooden plank is used, right? Wood is used. Glass, inlays of glasses are used, the pieces of glasses, even gold foil and some precious stones are also used for doing this painting. Next is Varli fog painting. It does not show image of deities. Deities means god or mythological characters. Instead, it is the depiction of the daily lives and social events of the Varli tribe of Maharashtra. Varli paintings use mostly white color with occasional dots in red and yellow on a mud base. Varli paintings are usually painted by women. Right? This Varli painting, it is done by the Varli tribe and it is made with white color. And only yellow and red color are used whenever necessary. Miniature painting. It is finely wrought and minutely detailed painting. Flourished in the Mughal period. It also became very popular in the Rajputana kingdoms where many styles and schools of miniature painting flourished. This painting are made on ivory panels. It is also made on leather, also on marble, cloth, walls, wooden tablets and even on papers. Colors made from precious stones, vegetables and minerals as well as pure gold and silver are used. So all the naturally made colors are used for this painting. Court scenes and hunting expeditions of kings are often the themes of these paintings. The name Bandhani, a technique of printing fabric, comes from the Sanskrit term Bandhana. Parts of the cloth are pinched and tied up before dyeing so that when the cloth is dried, the tied parts form patterns. And this Bandhani cloth is considered to be the symbol of girlhood and love. Kalamkari, that means artwork using a pen, is formed from two words, that is kalam, that is pen, and kari means work. The artist uses a bamboo pen or kalam and natural dyes to paint on cloth, that is cotton or silk fabric. The Kalamkari tradition chiefly consists of scenes of Hindu mythology. Let us take a quick quiz. What is the traditional Tibetan Buddhist painting called? It is called Thangka, THANGKA. Which style of embroidery is done with white cloth threads on plain muslin cloth? Lucknow in Uttar Pradesh is the chief center of this style. This style of embroidery is called chikankari. CHIKANKARI. Which Kashmiri papier mache art form uses flower motifs and is made on paper pulp objects? That is called Kari Kamandari. And the last one, name the famous form of embroidery from Punjab which literally means floral craft. That is called Fulkari. PHULKARI. Okay, that's all for today, children. We'll continue the other pages in the next session. Thank you.